a young Bible college graduate would have a chance encounter that would change his life and the course of his ministry. It was on this day in 1962. This young graduate was going through the city of London, heading back to his home country of Germany. He had one day where he could do a bit of sightseeing and bought a day pass for the city buses. He crisscrossed London and took in many things, and then he explains that he wanted to stretch his legs a bit. So he got down from the bus he was in, walked along one of the roads, and he says that to his great surprise, he looked up and saw a nameplate on a house that bore the name George Jeffreys. Now, as he said, I had read his books. He was the man that had brought the gospel of signs and wonders to the British Isles. Yes, George Jeffreys, the great evangelist, he had been saved in the Welsh Revival in 1904 and had gone on to a successful ministry, bringing the gospel throughout the British Isles. Great signs and wonders followed his ministry, blind eyes open, cripples walking, and he had many crusades throughout Europe as well. When he saw the nameplate, here is what this young man said. I rang the bell and a lady opened. I asked, is this George Jeffreys living here, the mighty revival evangelist? Yes, she said. May I please see him? No, she replied. Suddenly I heard a man's voice in the background. Let him in, he said. I saw him come down the staircase dressed as if for an appointment with the Queen. I introduced myself. He said nothing. He laid his hand on my shoulder, pulled me down onto the carpet with him, and started to bless me. The presence and glory of God struck me. When I left a half an hour later, I was staggering back to the bus stop and saying, Lord, how did I chance upon this address? And the Lord replied, the Holy Spirit was your bus driver. And I realized I had caught the mantle of George Jeffreys. For the very next day, George Jeffreys passed away. And of course, that young man was Reinhard Bonnke, who went on to become one of the greatest evangelists of the last part of the 20th century and the beginning of the 21st century. It all happened on this day, the 25th of January, 1962, a chance meeting orchestrated by the Holy Spirit as one spiritual giant passed on his mantle to a future spiritual giant.